sins and thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, and that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O people of Zion, behold, the Lord is nigh at hand to redeem the nations, and in the gladness of your heart the Lord shall cause his glorious voice to be heard.
Hear, O thou shepherd of Israel, thou that leadest Joseph like a sheep.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O people of Zion, behold, the Lord is nigh at hand to redeem the nations, and in the gladness of your heart the Lord shall cause his glorious voice to be heard. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ said. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Thine abbot obtain thy favor, that those things which we are not able to attain by our own merits, we may gain at this petition, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
The epistle is written in the 15th chapter of St. Paul's epistle to the Romans, beginning at the 4th verse. Whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we, through patience and comfort of the Scriptures, might have hope. Now the God of patience and consolation grant you to be like-minded one toward another according to Christ Jesus, that ye may with one mind and one mouth glorify God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Wherefore receive ye one another, as Christ also received us to the glory of God. Now I say that Jesus Christ was a minister of the circumcision for the truth of God, to confirm the promises made unto the fathers, and that the Gentiles might glorify God for his mercy, as it is written, "For this cause I will confess to thee among the Gentiles, and sing unto thy name." And again he saith, "Rejoice, ye Gentiles, with his people." And again, "Praise the Lord, all ye Gentiles, and laud him, all ye people." And again, Isaiah saith, "There shall be a root of Jesse, and he that shall rise to reign over the Gentiles, in him shall the Gentiles trust." Now the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, that ye may abound in hope through the power of the Holy Ghost. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God.
Out of Sion hath God appeared in perfect beauty. Gather my saints together unto me, those that have made a covenant with me with sacrifice.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. I was glad when they said unto me, "We will go to the house of the Lord." Hallelujah.
Thank you. shall be signs in the sun and in the moon, and in the stars and upon the earth, distresses of nations with perplexity. The sea, the waves roaring, men's hearts failing them for fear, and looking after those things which were coming on earth, for the powers of heaven shall be shaken. And then shall they see the Son of Man coming in the cloud with power and great glory. When these things begin to come to pass, then look up and lift your heads, for your redemption draweth nigh. And he spake to them a parable. Behold the fig tree, and all the trees, when now they shoot forth, ye see and know of your own selves that summer is now nigh at hand. So likewise ye, when ye see these things come to pass, know ye that the kingdom of God is nigh at hand. Verily I say unto you, this generation shall not pass away till all be fulfilled. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my words shall not pass away. Thus far the gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
Of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the principal Marian Holy Day.
Join us next Tuesday, December 21st at 6:30 p.m. for Grace, Grit, and Thanksgiving. We're going to have our Christmas carol sing. Light refreshments will be provided. Dr. Anthony is going to be playing piano and organ for us. It should be fun. Bring a friend. The next regular meeting of the St. Walburga Chapter of Daughters of the King is Sunday, December 12th at 11:45. Karen Lubakowski asked me to mention that any food that you're bringing in for the food pantry, please try to bring in by the 17th, because she's going to then take all the stuff to the food pantry for people to use for the holidays. So if you're planning on bringing something in, I can write that in there. But she mentioned it at the 8 o'clock service. If you're planning on bringing something in, try to get it in before the 17th. And today being the first Sunday of the month, all loose cash offerings go to the rector's discretionary fund. I think that's it as far as announcements go. Do we have any more? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
The word Advent means coming. In Advent, we consider the various comings of Jesus Christ. We look at those comings through the lens of the four last things. The four last things: death, judgment, heaven, and hell. Today, considering the scripture readings, we consider judgment. The Advent collect makes it clear: at the last day, Jesus will come in his glorious majesty to judge both the quick and the dead, the living and the dead. He came quietly the first time. Next time, he will come in such a way that no one will miss it. Next time, he is going to judge the living and the dead. The lessons for this morning are, in light of this overall theme, really rather sunny in tone. In the epistle, St. Paul tells us that if we read, mark, learn, and inwardly digest the Bible, the Holy Scriptures, then the Bible will comfort us with hope. In the Gospel, Jesus talks about the horrible calamities that will take place in the sky and on the earth just before he comes again. But then he adds, don't worry. Take that old song, don't worry, be happy. When all of these things start happening, don't hide under the bed. Instead, look up, lift up your heads. The end of the world means the coming of your redemption. When I come back, you are going to heaven. Why should you be scared at all? The hopeful and positive spin that Jesus and St. Paul both place upon the coming end of the world certainly suggests that we are going to get through the judgment successfully. So what is that judgment going to be? The judgment that Jesus will bring at the end of the world will be no different from the ones we are experiencing this morning. Perhaps we didn't know that we were facing judgment this morning. Let me tell you how it is happening. We are judged, first of all, by the summary of the law. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ said: thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and thy neighbor as thyself. And at the 8 o'clock service today, we read the Ten Commandments, the Decalogue. So we are judged by the Decalogue and the Ten Commandments. Jesus tells us that God's standard for our behavior is that we love him and love all our neighbors just as we love ourselves, all the time, no exceptions. When we measure ourselves by that standard, we experience God's judgment. Then come the lessons, the collect, the epistle, and the gospel. Do we live up to that for which the collect prays? Do we understand the epistle and the gospel enough to live by what they say? Measuring ourselves by the proper lessons is a further experience of God's judgment. The most explicit judgment comes later on, when the conditions under which we can presume to come to the altar to receive Holy Communion are recited. We have to repent of our sins, We have to be in love and charity with everybody else. We have to intend to lead a new life. The new life is the life we live in obedience to God's commandments rather than in slavery to our own self-centered whims. That is what judgment is. The judgment at the end of the world is going to take place after an extremely dramatic light show and the raising of all the dead people out of their graves and new bodies. And it's going to be in front of the risen and ascended Lord Jesus Christ, come back to earth in the flesh and on the clouds, who is going to be looking us right in the eye. The judgment in the end is going to take place under far more exciting circumstances than a quiet Sunday morning at a pretty little Maryland church with the comfort of padded pews and the lovely prayer book language. But it is going to be fundamentally identical. The question at the judgment is the same as the question the prayer book service asks. Did you keep all God's laws perfectly? There is no, I did not. There's no way to escape the truth. St. Paul says, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. All. You and me. We cannot evade the judgment. The verdict is on everyone, guilty as charged. We can't say, but look at all the good I did. We won't be allowed to blame it all on our parents, or our ill-advised marriage, or on the fact that we thought God really didn't mean it when he said, go to church every Sunday and pray and read the Bible every day. Our favorite rationalizations and self-delusion and denials are just not going to work. The issue will not be, am I guilty? We are guilty, let me assure you. The issue will be, do I admit it? Am I sorry about it? Am I willing to accept the fact that the only way I can escape the consequences of God's guilty verdict is to say, Jesus died for me. Jesus already took the punishment I deserve. That is what we're getting in practice for every Sunday, whether we realize it or not. We say it in the confession when we acknowledge that our bad behavior has provoked most justly God's wrath and indignation against us. And then we ask God for mercy, and we claim it with confidence, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. The judgment at the end will be like the judgment now. The way to find out is to read and study the Bible and pay attention to what is going on Sunday morning. That's the way to find that out. We are here to get ready for the end. We are here to get used to facing the judgment of God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Wilt thou not turn again, O God, and quicken us, that thy people may rejoice in thee? Show us thy mercy, O Lord, and grant us thy salvation.
Remember the words of the Lord Jesus, how he said it is more blessed to give than to receive.
Thank you.
offer the Holy Eucharist to the praise, honor, and glory of God, for all of those on our parish prayer list, those whom we mention in the secrecy of our hearts, and for all the faithful departed in Christ. Rest the eternal, grant unto them, O Lord.
That the midnight perpetual shine upon them.
May the souls of the faithful departed through the mercies of God rest in peace.
Amen.
Pray, Reverend, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord receive the sacrifice at thy hands to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church. Amen.
Accept, we beseech thee, O Lord, the prayers and oblations of thy humble servants, that we who can do nothing of ourselves to help ourselves may be ever defended by thy gracious aid, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's Church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations, and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal Church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word, and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice, to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen.
Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession to Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Almighty God,
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and beware of our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and we are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in the business of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ hath unto all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul said. This is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John said. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me.
thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, a memorial thy Son hath commanded, blessed passion and precious death and glorious ascension, rendering all benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and with thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that, by the merit and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. Here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we, and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion, may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy, through our manifold sins, to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee. O Father Almighty, world without end. Amen. Let us pray. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
and our souls washed through his most precious blood.
and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen.
Body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserved by body and soul unto everlasting life.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee, for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us, who have fully received these holy mysteries, with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom in thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen.
O Lord, who hast vouchsafed to satisfy us with heavenly sustenance, we humbly beseech thee that by participation in this mystery, thou wouldst teach us to despise earthly things and to love such things as are heavenly, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.